Hello friends, welcome to Tech Talks Engineered channel. Today we will see what is thermal imaging of equipment and conductors at electrical substation. First of all, let's see what happens if thermal imaging is not done regularly. We can see clearly a hot spot on isolator palm and can see sparking. If such hot spots are not attended timely, then it can break the palm, nut bolt or the conductor. This leads to unwanted breakdown. With this example, it is evident that regular thermal imaging of electrical equipment and conductors is necessary to identify thermal anomalies and prevent possible breakdown. Now, let's see, how do we do thermal imaging? It is done with the help of infrared camera. At some substations, infrared camera is fixed at one location, and it covers certain area of the substation. Hence, to cover complete substation, multiple cameras are fixed at different suitable locations. At some substations, handheld portable infrared camera is used. This portable camera is moved around, and complete substation is scanned manually for thermal anomalies. Now, let's see some cases. In this picture, first half is a thermal image of the equipment, and second half is an actual image of the same equipment. In this pic, we can see thermal image and actual image of CT. In this CT thermal image, CT terminal temperature is 122.5 degrees Celsius, and it looks bright and yellow as compared to other parts of the CT. Such hot spots cannot be located with naked eyes. Let's see next image. In this image, CT terminal temperature is 76.5 degrees Celsius. Moving on. In this image, isolator palm temperature is 127.7 degrees Celsius. In next image, we can see, isolator rod temperature is 69.8 degrees Celsius. In this case, the part of the rod which is fitted inside the jaw shows high temperature. In this image, bus T jumper temperature is 118 degrees Celsius. Now, we can see circuit breaker top palm temperature is 101.9 degrees Celsius. All these cases of hot spots should be attended as early as possible for normal and smooth functioning of the electrical substation. This picture is taken at night. We can see a hot spot on circuit breaker bottom palm. We can see, among these four nut bolts, one nut bolt is glowing. That's why it is visible at night without infrared camera. But, since it is literally glowing, its temperature must be very high, and it can break at any time. And this is not a desirable condition. Hence, to avoid such situation, it is necessary to do thermal imaging regularly. Hence, early detection of excessive heat in an electrical system allows the utility to schedule maintenance of the particular equipment and avoid expensive breakdown. On other hand, complete absence of heat is also an indication of an anomaly. Since in charged condition, electrical system has some normal operating temperature. Periodic scanning is very useful. Temperature indicated during thermal imaging depend upon multiple factors, such as ambient temperature, humidity, wind, and load on the equipment. If ambient temperature is high or load is high, temperature of the equipment would be relatively higher. While keeping these factors in mind, it is more meaningful to use comparative measurement. That is, comparing the temperature of two similar and equally loaded electrical equipment. This method automatically cancels out other environmental factors, such as ambient temperature, humidity and wind, etc. For example, in a balanced three-phase equipment or conductors, there should not be a significant difference in temperature readings of each phase of the equipment. Generally, in an electrical substation, connecting palms, crimping lugs and clamps develop hot spots. In a nutshell, all the conductor joints or connection points in an electrical substation are likely to develop hot spots. Oxidation of conductor joints or loose joints develop hot spots. A conductor with broken strands also develop excessive heat, and it is necessary to replace such conductors. One of the transformer checkpoints are cooling system. Cool spots in radiator indicates blockage of the vent. Also, temperature anomalies in cooling fan indicate electrical or mechanical problem in the fan. Also in transformer, thermal imaging of OLTC that is on load tap changer is done. Usually OLTC tank temperature should be equal or lower than the transformer tank temperature. High temperature of OLTC indicates problem in tap changer, diverter chamber or tap connections. Also transformer bushings and their connections should be checked. Nowadays, the infrared technology has changed from analog to digital, resulting in improved image quality. At some substations, infrared camera data is transferred manually and then analyzed. At some utilities, temperature scanning is automated, camera images are digitized, stored and transferred to control centers in real time. So guys, this is all about thermal imaging of equipment and conductors at electrical substation. Hope you like the video. If yes, please hit the like button. For more videos, please subscribe. Thank you.